are now starting Unit 10 on analyzing literary text, and this is the introductory lesson. So there is a portfolio in this particular unit that I am skipping. Okay, so let me just say this again. There is not going to be a portfolio for this particular unit, okay? We will be doing one in Unit 14. So we are not going to do the portfolio that is in this unit, okay? So if you see any lessons that mention the portfolio, just ignore the portfolio part because we're not going to do that. You will have a unit test instead. Okay, so, and on the unit test, you may have to analyze some different things when you are answering open response questions, okay? So just keep that in mind. You do need this information. You do need to be able to do analysis on literary text for your unit test for the open response questions. So please go through these lessons like you normally would. And let's go ahead and just start with what is literary text and what is a literary analysis. So remember that literary text is an imaginary piece of writing. You guys just wrote your short story for the last unit. So it can be things like the short story that you wrote. They can be novels, poems. They can also be like scripts for movies or TV series, those kind of things, okay? Now, there are different strategies that you can use to analyze text, and you will look at story structure, point of view of the characters, and literary devices. So those are the things that you mostly will use to analyze text. So what exactly is a literary analysis? Well, it involves breaking down a text structure and content into smaller pieces so that you get a better understanding of that text, okay? So an analysis can discuss things like the components of the individual text and how they relate to one another, how two separate literary texts deal with similar concepts or forms, or how those concepts and forms in literary texts relate to a larger political or social context or religious or even economical context, okay? So it can address a whole bunch of things, like things in society, okay? So let's go ahead and watch a short video on looking at the deeper meaning of literature.
We often hear that studying literature involves finding a deeper meaning to a text. When writing about literary works, we're expected to mentally dive below the surface in order to come back up with big ideas. But you may find yourself looking at the flat page of a book, wondering how deep it can really go. How do we reach those ideas that turn into great essays? Well, there are two crucial thinking steps that can lead us in the right direction: practicing insight and acknowledging complexity. Insight is the ability to arrive at an intuitive understanding of a big idea using only small clues to get there. If you're practicing insight, you'll be able to use observations about character behavior to figure out their true emotions and motivations. Pay attention to little things, because they add up to what is really meaningful. For example, if you consider a character like Mr. Darcy from Pride and Prejudice, who openly declares his dislike for Miss Lizzie Bennet, you might at first assume he's just a mean guy. But using your powers of insight, you're noticing other smaller things, how Darcy's eyes linger on Lizzie's face and how he seems all flustered when she's around. Add to the mix your knowledge that Mr. Darcy is in a much higher social class than Lizzie, and your sense of insight should be telling you that there's something more here. In this case, it will tell you that Darcy's surface behavior is in conflict with his true feelings of attraction, because the difference in wealth between himself and Lizzie makes him feel that it'll never work. Thinking about all those small clues gives us insight about some of the big abstract ideas within the novel that we can approach in an essay: appearances versus reality, the power of wealth and social stratification, and the unpredictable nature of love and attraction. Look at that! Deeper meaning. The second step to a sophisticated analysis is acknowledging complexity. Let's face it, in both life and literature, situations are complicated due to social forces like relationships, moral codes, personal desires, and power structures. This means that there are, at any given time, multiple factors that shape what is true. In order to acknowledge complexity in your writing, refrain from making broad generalizations about a text or establishing quick, simple judgments about a character. Explore each facet of your subject carefully, and make sure to consider multiple influences on events. Explain the tension of multiple forces that create the story. For example, a basic analysis of Toni Morrison's Beloved, where the protagonist has killed her own child rather than allow her to grow up in slavery, might sound like this. Setha murdered her own daughter. This act was wrong, and causes the ghost of the child to haunt her throughout the novel. These observations are simplistic. They don't acknowledge all the different forces that contribute to what the character has done. Try something like this instead. A culture of slavery disturbs the ability to determine what is morally right. Setha's past experiences with violence reinforce the fear she has for her child's fate and transform the murder into a protective act. As the novel progresses, Setha is haunted both by the angry spirit of her daughter and by the memories of everything else slavery took from her. Here, we see those influential forces at work, and we've shown off our ability to understand the complicated nature of the human experience, which again allows us to access those big ideas that reveal the deeper meaning of a story. Ideas in this case, like the parameters of maternal instinct, the consequences of injustice, and the question of whether or not ethics can even exist in a corrupted moral system. It's impossible to sit down and write an amazing essay about literature without first thinking about it. Before you hit the keys, go back to the text and fish out the small moments, the complicated moments in the story. Line them up in your mind, practice insight, acknowledge complexity, arrive at some big ideas. Before you know it, the deeper meaning will be close at hand.